it's that time to wrap up a great celebration. Can I see some spirit sprinkles out there from our readers? Oh, yes, you got it. I tell you what, this has been a phenomenal 2 weeks of celebrating awesome, awesome reading. I have seen so many friends read and pick up books and be adventurous in reading, and I love it. This has been a phenomenal 2 weeks of celebrating great reading. We're going to continue the celebration next week with our book fair. So exciting. I am so proud of you. Each and one of you have worked so hard to fill out those bingo boards and just enjoy reading. And that's really what this all has been about, is about celebrating reading so that you can see that reading opens up the world to us. Reading is really a place where we can fill our minds with curiosities and continue to be a lifelong learner. Today, I have a wonderful book that I want to share with you. This is a book that I often read to my classroom when I had my own classroom over at Norwich. So I wanted to share it with you today as a way to wrap up, and then I'll share a few final thoughts here at the end. So right now, let me go ahead and share that beautiful book with you. And let's get ready to enjoy our final read aloud. So without much further ado, here we go. All right, beautiful friends, this is our final book. The book is If You Plant a Seed, and the words and the paintings are by Kadir Nelson. Now, here's what I will tell you. Many of the books that you will read nowadays, like the more current newly published books, those illustrations are usually done more on like an iPad or a tablet or on a computer. What I love about this book that Kadir does is that each one of these illustrations are actual paintings. They're on a canvas. And so when you read this book, you can actually see the texture of the canvas and the paint. It's just beautiful, as well as Kadir's message. Let's keep reading. Here we go. If you plant a seed. If you plant a tomato seed, a carrot seed, and a cabbage seed, and look here, planting right there. In time, and with love and care, and notice how here they are, they've planted it, they've patted it in. In time, look, it's gonna get a little wet and messy, but they're looking over their plants. With love and care, do you see what's poked out? Thumbs up, do you see what's happened? Look, I see some cabbage poking. Oh, there's some carrot. Let's see, here we go. Tomato, carrot, and cabbage plants will grow. Oh, look at those beautiful plants. Yum, yum, yum. Mm. And look at our wonderful characters here. They're as excited as we are. And look what they're doing. They're celebrating and they're enjoying the feast of what they nurtured and they took care of. Wonderful. But uh-oh, here's where there's something that happens. Notice how we've got our joyous rabbit and mouse here, but then some new people show up. Thumbs up, thumbs down. Do you think it's gonna be good news that these birds showed up? What do you think? Good news, bad news? What do you think? I don't know. Let's see how this goes. Uh-oh, they're looking. Can you look, ready? Look real close. Oh dear, I wonder what those birds are thinking. Let's see. Oh dear, if you plant a seed of selfishness in a very short time, oh dear, it will grow and grow and grow.
What?
Now let's go back. Let's think about this. It mentioned this word about if you plant a seed of selfishness. So you want to know, what does that mean? What does that mean to be selfish? What does that mean to be selfish? Mr. Hawthorne, I see that you have a friend there, that they have a raised hand. Can you unmute yourself? What does that mean to be selfish?
Hi, Diana.
Like you like yourself and be mean.
Yeah. It means to be mean and you're only thinking about yourself. Good job. Good job, Hawthorne friends. You got it. So all of a sudden, Kadir's telling us, like, wait, if you plant a seed in selfishness, and in a very short time, look what's going to happen. That selfishness is going to grow, grow, grow. And look what's happened. Thumbs up, thumbs down. Do we have a positive community there? Yikes. Oh, no, we don't. Look at that. Look at what the rabbit's doing. The rabbit's not sharing. Look what the mouse is doing. The mouse is throwing a tomato. Yikes. And look what it grows into, a heap. Oh, what a mess. What a mess. But if you plant a seed of kindness, now you know, Mrs. Rip, this is my word. This is my jammy word. Let's see what happens if you plant a seed in the understanding and this mindset of kindness. What can happen then? In almost no time, the fruits of kindness, look, because they shared, look what the birds are doing. They're sharing as well, aren't they? They're being kind. Look to see what happens next. It will grow and grow and grow and grow. Look at that garden. The garden was not planted out of selfishness so that the food was not only just not for just only the rabbit and the mouse, but because they shared and they planted seeds together and they nurtured, and this garden was planted out of kindness. Look at the bounty that is there. And they are very, very sweet. There's enough food for everyone, isn't there? There's enough food for everyone. Now, why on earth did Mrs. Rip choose this book? Here's the end. Why did I choose this book? Well, there's several reasons. This book really, to me, is not about planting seeds. It's really, if you know Mrs. Rip, it's all about symbolism. When I think about the beginning of this story, it seems innocent enough, right? That we're planting seeds. But what do we know about seeds? Seeds give us hope, right? Of what is to come. But if we plant seeds of selfishness, where we're out in the world with our friends and we're only thinking about ourselves and we don't share with others, are the results good? No. But when we think about what we can offer to our friends, and acts of kindness, right? Like helping to help someone in need. Maybe they dropped their pencil. Maybe a friend fell and we helped them up. Maybe we're sprinkling kindness and flooding our school with that kindness of just being a kind, wonderful, welcome human being. Our bounty then is this. We are all full and filled with kindness, and we all reap that bounty. And that's really the message of this book. This book is more than just about planting physical seeds in the ground. They're about planting this idea of metaphorical seeds, this idea that we are farmers. We are all farmers in our lives, and that we have this potential to nurture the relationships that we want with the people that are around us. And if we want others to treat us kindly, then we should, number one, be kind back. We should be kind back. And that's the message. I hope that you also understand that if we want to be curious learners and we want to succeed, the spirit of this readathon is really in this book as well. Your teachers are wonderful farmers in the sense of they are planting the seeds of knowledge and curiosity. But it's up to you to nourish that garden as well so that you continue to grow as learners and readers. I am so thankful that you have been able to join me here all throughout this wonderful readathon. It has been a pleasure to be here at Beacon. Just my first year, I have gotten to know so many of you, and what a wonderful way to wrap up and just enjoy a wonderful good book. Thumbs up if that book just touched your heart like it touched Mrs. Rip's heart. It did. It speaks to my heart. I love this book. A wonderful book. It's available for you if you want to check it out. It's out here in our IDC. It's in book bin number 50. So if you're interested in it, It's there. If you want to get it, it's a wonderful book. Thank you so much for coming today. And guess what? We're going to dance this party out because today is all about you. I see your awesome, wonderful cartoons. I dressed up as Hermione. Here's my little Crookshanks. Ready? Stand up. Let's dance it. Here we go. Good job, Deacon. Happy Readathon. Looking good, Deacon. Have a wonderful Friday. Woohoo! I'll see you next week at the book fair.